Hey guys, it's Gotham Gaming here. I have a gameplay of Team Deathmatch on Sideshow, but that's not what I'm talking about today. I'm talking about E3. E3, the main part of E3, at least for me, is finished. I'm going to be talking about the Bethesda and Sony conference. Here's the deal. Now, with Bethesda, we saw Doom 4, which, whew. Doom 4 is going to be a great game. I have the beta already. I'm just waiting to download it. I cannot wait to play Doom 4. The gruesome and 90s hit action game Doom, like, holy shit, I cannot wait to play Doom 4. This is just called Doom, but it's the fourth Doom. Cannot wait. They have a new thing called Snap Map where you can create your own maps. It's really cool. I highly recommend you guys go check that out. Critical Hit 64 did a whole thing on his channel about Snapchat Map. You can see that it's a bit more in depth. They showed a teaser trailer for Dishonored 2. That looked pretty cool. I played Dishonored 1, it was pretty good, so I'm excited for that. Excuse me. Drinking my premium apple juice. I saw this little, I don't know if it was indie or not. If it's from Bethesda, it's not indie. Battle Cry 2. It looked like a little interesting third person shooter, something I'd try out. Now, to the meat and potatoes. The gold mine. The holy grail of the Bethesda conference, and probably my favorite part, well, one of my favorite parts of the CE3, Fallout 4. This game is gonna be good. It is good. I haven't even played it. It's good. It's good. Just take my word for it. They talked so much about Fallout 4. I was so excited and happy about that they talked that much about Fallout 4. It's great. I'm glad the game's getting all the hype it is. And the best part is, we don't have to wait too much longer. This is the game comes out November 10th, 2015. That, I believe, is the second Tuesday of November. So I cannot wait. Now, I also saw they trailed off the Collector's Edition. And inside the Collector's Edition comes a life-size Pip-Boy that you can put your cellular device in, your cell phone, download an app and make it a fully functioning Pip-Boy, which I think that's badass. I might pop up a screenshot of the Pip-Boy in the middle of this video just so you guys can see it. I'm not sure yet. If not, you can look it up. It looks amazing. And he said there's gonna be a second screen experience with the Pip-Boy, and he says most second screen experiences are gimmicky bullshit. But let me tell you, this is the best gimmicky bullshit there is. And let me tell you, damn straight, this Pip-Boy looks badass. I want to get the Collector's Edition. I don't know if I am or not, but if I do, a full unboxing will be on this channel. And I will be doing coverage of Fallout 4. Now, something you can get now is a game called Fallout Shelter. You can get it on Google Play Store, Android Marketplace, App Store. It's called Fallout Shelter, and essentially it's an iPhone game of Fallout. It's really fun. I've been playing it nonstop. It's really good. And it's free. It's free. It's good. It's not like most microtransactions. There's only one little thing, but it's not necessary. You don't have to buy it. When you build stuff, it builds instantly. There's no waiting or paywall. It is a great free-to-play game. It makes me have faith that more AAA games will do this and have other style games like this. The game is magnificent, to say the least. Fallout Shelter, that is what it's called. Bethesda the studio's created. Great game. Now, Sony's E3 press conference had lots of things. Start off, The Last Guardian. Now, in case you do not know what The Last Guardian is, it's a game they haven't talked about. They haven't really talked about it. They showed a lot of different things. It first got announced, I think I want to say E3 2005. Supposed to come out on the PS3. This game is supposed to be, it's supposed to be coming out. We've been waiting a while. Now, it did show, if I remember correctly, 2016, The Last Guardian. It's going to be coming out 2016. And then after that, we got Hitman. That game looked ultra realistic. It looked beautiful. I cannot wait for Hitman. Then we have Street Fighter V. And there's an exclusive to PlayStation. And there's going to be an exclusive beta on July 23rd of this year. Now, another game they're talking about, No Man's Sky. That game, I don't understand what all the hype's about, but once I actually saw it, I can understand why. It's like a huge universe, tons of stuff to talk about, look at. I don't even know how they're gonna fit it on the console, to be honest, but that's gonna be impressive. Firewatch looked interesting. Firefighter, typical damsel in distress. I don't really know. It looked really cool, though. I'd like to play that. Now, they talked about Destiny. They talked about the new expansion, Destiny, the Taken King. And they also talked about how Destiny will be getting exclusive content only on PlayStation. After that, they showed Assassin's Creed Syndicate, which is Assassin's Creed, enough said. Looked pretty cool. They showed Final Fantasy VII Remake. There's gonna be a remaster of Final Fantasy VII. They had a Kickstarter for Shenmue 3. Batman Arkham Knight, which was really surprising. You played as, I wanna say, Gordon from the movies. You didn't play as Batman in the teaser trailer they showed off. That was interesting. Now, they did do Black Ops 3, but I'm gonna make a separate video for that, because there's a lot to talk about in Black Ops 3. And also, they talked about Project Morpheus, the VR headset that Sony's working on. That's gonna be cool. And also, lo and behold, Uncharted 4. This game is gonna be magnificent, no questions asked. And that's about really all for E3. It was an okay year. Fallout 4 for sure was probably my favorite part, or the Black Ops 3, but I think Fallout 4 took the cake for me this year. Anyway, guys, this is Maxmel here from Gotham Gaming. Peace the fuck out.